Mic check. Hey, yo, guys, gals, everybody out there. I appreciate y'all guys clicking on this video and stopping by the channel to check out this Montero or this Lil Nas X debut album reaction. We did this live on stream. It's fully edited down to only the important parts. But let me go ahead and tell you, this album, I was not ready for it whatsoever. You're going to see that's like the running theme of the entire review, that every song I just wasn't ready for. In my mind, I had some type of like vision for what I thought Lil Nas X would do on his debut album, and it wasn't this whatsoever. Like I said, we did this live on Twitch. I stream over on Twitch 4 to 5 days a week for a couple of hours at a time. And on Thursdays, we do requests either from Patreon, from YouTube, or from Twitch. And on Fridays, we do New Music Friday. And today, it was Lil Nas X's album along with a couple of other singles that were out there. If this is not your first time on the channel, if you really enjoy the vibe of the channel and you enjoy my vibe and the way that I break down and give you my thoughts and analysis and review of the things that I make videos on, then I promise you, even if you've never joined a live stream before, if you're not really even somebody that really fucks with live streams, I promise you, you will enjoy the live stream for this community because you get to interact with other people that are here for what I do, and I get to interact with you and vice versa. It's a completely different atmosphere. So if y'all guys want to check it out, it's free to do. It's the second link in the description. Actually, if you're an Amazon Prime member, you can support the channel monetarily through Twitch by using your Amazon Prime for free. You get a free subscription to any Twitch streamer. But that's it. I just wanted to let y'all know how this video came about. And if y'all guys want to join us, feel free. I would love to have you. We would all love to have you. It's just a different aspect of the community that you know and love on YouTube. I really appreciate your time for checking this video out. Like I always say, go out there in the world, love and care for one another and each other. And I'll catch everybody on the next video. Enjoy this, guys. I think what we're going to start with is a little Lil Nas X, because I'm curious to see what this album is going to sound like. All right. So for those that don't know, Lil Nas X, that was the wrong screen. That was my bad. That one. For those that don't know, Lil Nas X, this is his debut album. His debut album. He's put out, you know, all those fucking Old Town Road, all that shit. And then he put out the Twerking on the Devil track, and then he put out Industry Baby. So obviously he's kind of all over the place. I don't know if y'all are down. Y'all have to be, because I'm the one that's running the show. We heard Montero, Call Me By Your Name, which is the one where he like came out as gay, or, you know, we knew he was, but he wrote a song about it. Industry Baby, we heard that with Jack Harlow. Let's hear this Dead Right Now. This is the second track on the album.
Somebody come get this bitch. Think hey. You're a star on the rise. You got time to reply. Don't lie. You can hit my shit.
Hey. All right. So this is a fucking bop already. The cadence is crazy. I wasn't expecting like this type of rap from Lil Nas X because of, you know, what he's put out recently. A lot of Lil Nas X, if you don't know, is trolling. He's like, oh, y'all don't like me coming out as gay? Let me go ahead and make a whole song and video about it with Industry Baby. Oh, you don't like me twerking on the devil? Let me make some blood shoes. So it's all trolling. So I didn't know what it was gonna sound like. But this right here is my
sweet. I'll treat you like you're dead right now. I'm on your head.
Bro, this is fire, guys. And not even like, oh, Lil Nas X, he's like, he's funny, he's a cool guy heat. This is like heat. You know what I'm saying? New Jersey in the house. So we got New Jersey, we got New York, the Bronx, we got everywhere. We got Sweden in the house. Vodgordu. How are y'all feeling about this? Are y'all thinking that this is fire? Or is that just me? Florida in the house? Netherlands in the house? H-Town down. UK in the house? Nevada in the house? Cali in the house? Worldwide vibes. I'm basically Pitbull. I'm Mr. Worldwide. Egypt? Hey, Nader, in case you don't know, I don't know how brushed up you are on Egyptian names and history and kings and pharaohs and all that. Nima's name is, her full name is Nimatep, which is a queen in the pharaoh days. I forgot when she reigned, but she's a queen. Greyhounds are said, like the folklore around greyhounds is that they're the oldest dog breed going back to biblical and Egyptian, biblical Egypt. So I was like, let me name her something out of Egyptian history. Oh my God.
Said it's 1 million me and 10 cents, and I told him, daddy, I am never wanna. I ain't even need no feature. If I didn't blow, I would've died trying to be here.
He going ham right now. He said, my dad didn't even accept me. Fuck it. I didn't need him anyway. And then he said, I need no feature. If I didn't blow on my own, I was gonna die trying to get here. Get rich or die and try type beat.
Die trying to be here. Yep. If it didn't go suicide, I wouldn't be here. Then they all come around, let they be here. Hallelujah, how'd you do it? You've been on my mind, you've been running through it. You know you never used to call, keep it that way now. I treat you like you're dead right now.
This is basically the gay version of Shot For Me by Drake. Not just kidding, not the gay version. But this is Lil Nas X's version of Take a Shot For Me by Drake. This is fucking dope right here.
You like it dead right now.
Oh, I'm on your head right now.
When she get drunk, she hit me up, mad with a fever like, whoa. You ain't even out that pretty. You ain't having now with me, God won't forgive me. Keep it that way now. Treat you like you're dead right now.
Oh! Guys, that might be like a 9 for me. Easy 8. I think I'm rating it as high as I am because I wasn't expecting this from Lil Nas X. And I don't know why I wasn't expecting it, because a gay black dude in a very heterosexual alpha male style industry, I don't think I was expecting him, especially with his lead up singles like Industry Baby and Montero, like with those singles that are very trolly in their nature. I don't think I was expecting anything like this. And I don't know why, because I'm sure there was crazy amount of tribulation just being a gay black dude. You're already in the minority as a black dude, and then you're in the extra minority as a gay dude, and then in the gay community, you're black, so you're a minority there. So he's already starting way from the bottom. And I don't know why that never clicked in my head, but this is fire. I wasn't expecting any emotion like this from him. I fuck with this. Montero was the first track. Dead Right Now is the second track. Industry Baby is the third. Let's go to track number 4, 5, and then we'll end it. Oh, fuck. I can't even end it on 4, 5, and 6. I wanted to check out That's What I Want, and I was like, let me end it with the one with Doja Cat, which is Scoop. And then I look right under that. Track number 7 is One of Me featuring Elton John. The king of the gate.
Tell me lies, we can argue, we can fight. Yeah, we did it before, but we'll do it tonight. Yeah, that fro black boy with the gold teeth, giving love away, but I want.
Oh, bro. Lil Nas X is that dude, bro. He's that motherfucker. I know for a fact that all of y'all out there, just like me, did not expect anything like this. Y'all were expecting trolling. Y'all were expecting one-hit wonder. You thought he's milking the fuck out of Old Town Road. All right, Industry Baby's kind of good, but it might be carried by Jack Harlow a little bit. You thought, okay, Montero's kind of cool, but the video is really gay. So you might have had like he's like a gimmicky type of, he's a meme. He's like 6'9". He's popular because of the memeage that he is. You weren't expecting this right here. I wasn't expecting this right here.
An adversary to my down and rare. Like, tell me that's life when I'm stressing at night. This days I'm way too alone, and I'm not forgiving love away, but I want someone who needs me, someone who loves me. I need. Cause it don't feel like,
oh my god.
It's just me and my dreams. That's what I fucking want.
Bro, I'm fucking with the album. We're 4 tracks in. He's like telling a story. He's telling a story of like the angst of growing up, you know, and realizing that he's gay. He probably tried to hide it for a long time. He probably doesn't come from the safest or you know, cleanest neighborhood, so he's gonna be ostracized. So there's like a lot of pain and emotion behind the lyrics. But the song slaps. You know who would have been fire on that track? Doja Cat. I kind of want to see her go into like that lane right there. I think that she would be perfect for like that kind of rock, pop, you know, lane. That's like an 8 for me. I honestly expected to like listen to maybe 5 tracks on the album, kind of vibe with y'all, laugh at the fucking lyrics, laugh at, oh my god, he's such a troll. Nah. All right, next up, we got Scoop. For those that don't know, Doja Cat is probably my favorite female rapper. Besides like Lil Sims and like all the lyrical female rappers. If you put up Doja Cat with Nicki, Cardi B, Meg Thee Stallion, and Doja Cat, those, they kind of all fit in the same category together. Doja Cat is by far my favorite one. Like, not even close. She's more talented than the rest in general. So I'm always excited when she has a feature.
Ever seen a nigga hit Pilates?
Hey.
I've been in the crib going crazy. Understand, I'm just trying to be the daily. Scoop. Scoop. Scoop.
Tell me you don't hear Doja Cat already, her voice. They looking at my wrist, now watch it hit back. Hey. My head get flown and it sit back. And I won't call on the phone if I hit that. Understand, I'm just trying to be the daily. Scoop. Scoop, that is. But her toes got me tight, look at the payoff. Ooh. And now my body look like something you need take off. I just got my fingers up. I love her cadence and I love her voice. I know people are not going to like her like high-pitched whine. It's like kind of like nasally baby voice. But I like that because it's different than your average like female rapper who's all a lot of female rappers because they're rappers and rap is generally 99% men and it's 99% aggressive most of the time. They try to sound like mad aggressive. You know what I'm saying? And that shit is like, just do you. Stop trying to be a dude rapper. So I like that she's like, fuck it. I'm going to go extra over the top with my female voice. Hey. Scoop is probably like a 7.5 for me. I don't think it's as good as Dead Right Now or That's What I Want because those are like powerful lyrics, I guess you could say. Like he's letting us into the vulnerability of being a gay black man and like all the worries and all the like things that come with that. Scoop is more just like a fun song. Doja Cat, she has a solid verse. Her delivery is fire, but it's not going to hit me in the way that the other ones did, especially after The Art of Realization. I was expecting like a very heavy track after that. So it might just be in the order that it's in, but it was decent. I'm excited about this next one. This next one is the one with Elton John. Say you wanna be, yeah, yeah. I like this, I don't like that. Word on the pockets, you fell off and I'm just saying, if it ain't Old Town Road, Lil Nas, you ain't playing, nigga. I'm just saying, if it ain't Old Town Road, you ain't gonna blow up. You see what I mean? He's talking to fucking me. Cause I didn't think he was gonna get past Old Town Road. There was like 9,000 fucking remakes and remixes. I was like, all right, guys, we're milking the fuck out of this Old Town Road. The song's already 2 years old at this point. But here we are. I'm fucking with the album. No, it hurt your soul to know it was only luck. If you drop a song, nigga, we won't give a fuck, no. Yeah, you had a song, but if you drop a whole album, you drop another song, no one's gonna fuck with it. Say you one of me, say you one of me, yeah, yeah. See, like, it's like, say you one of me. I feel threatened by you, so say you're one of me. This is what I like, what I don't like. You gotta stay in the lane that I like. All the things that you do just to get your face to show. Ain't the next big thing, you the next thing to go. Now, ooh, can you prove yourself? You ain't the next big thing, Lil Nas X. You're the next thing to go. I don't see you lasting long, and that's just me being honest. Even if your album okay is flopping, that's a promise. So I like this, I don't like that. Yeah. Elton didn't actually have a verse. I wonder if Elton was on the piano in the background. Or did he provide like background vocals that were layered and stacked into the instrumental? If it was me curating the album, right? Like in order, I might have started with Dead Right Now over Montero, but Montero's fine too. Because he's like, that's basically the song saying, you know, I'm coming out as who I am. Call me by my name. But after The Art of Realization, I would probably have put one of me after that and then Scoop after that. So that was like a 7.5. It might have been higher than that. It might have been an 8, but I think I was disappointed that Elton didn't have a verse. But it makes sense that he's on the keys. He's not the only artist that does that where he provides, like Santana, for example. Anytime something's featuring Santana, he's not singing. Do we want to keep going with the album or do we want to switch it up? Keep going with the album? All right, bet. Next up, we got Lawson Citadel. I forgot what city that is. Are you happy? Do your dreams still sing? I need time to get up and get out the floor. I love it, I know I'll only come right back for more. I remember when I met you. Thought the universe sent you. I need time to get up and bro, get out the floor. This is nice. Let me tell you what this is right here. This is Lil Nas X's version of Tickets to My Downfall by MGK. That's what this album is. Also, put ones if you're fucking with it, twos if you're not. Bro. Hot Topic shopping goth vibes. me out there trying to pick my fucking band t-shirts off the wall with my 12 multicolored fucking plastic rubber bands. Another banger, guys. And there's no miss for me so far on this album. Crazy. Was that a miss? Somebody tell me if y'all thought that missed. 1 to 10. Where are we at? That's like an 8 for me. Can this album be in my top 10 albums of the year at the end of the year? That's your favorite track? Honestly, that might be my favorite track on the album too. I did like Dead Right Now a lot. But that right there was solid. 9, 8.5. That one, this is a fun album. 8, 8.5, 7. 9.5. All right, let me tell you what. I didn't think that he was as decent of a singer as he is. You know, rappers sing sometimes. They try to sing their own hooks. They put auto-tune on the voice a little bit. Some rappers can pull it off. Like, J. Cole can kind of pull it off. You can tell he's not a singer, but he can, like, sing in tune at least. I think Lil Nas X is a pretty decent singer. All right, next up, we got $Slime. This is the one with Meg Thee Stallion.
Y'all take a room and y'all going wear it out.
The 808 is crazy.
I'm the same $Slime, nigga.
Sheesh.
Top of the game, only 22. Look at me, nigga, they ain't look at you.
Ooh.
Cutest the opp, you know I don't got too major. Bought a new house, few acres. I don't ain't got new neighbors. Fuck all that talk about who's in the whereabouts.
The horn is crazy.
I'm the same $Slime.
Bro. The horns, the production, the way the horn was just in the left ear and then it came back and then the production came in. He's not saying anything crazy right here. It's like typical rap that I would expect, especially with Meg on the track. But what's impressive about it is that he's like floating and weaving his way through all these different lanes right now. It's crazy nice that he's able to like bounce from style to style and pretty much pull them all off. I haven't heard a miss yet. This is a song that you vibe with in 2K and while you're creating your character. This is 100%.
I'm the
2K.
They can't stop me. Say I can't do it, bitch. Watch me. I should have my own category in point. Ooh, I'm just such an obsession.
That was not a bar, guys. Watching me turn you on, I should have my own category in porn. Weak, Meg.
No at on prosthetics. Everything about me came from genetics. All these hoes imitate me. You can fuck a stand or the real slim shady. Toxic, suck a soul out, then blocking.
Uninventive by Meg. I 100% wish that she wasn't on this song. All right, guys. $Slime. It was just a 7. Might give it a 6.5 because I didn't think Meg showed up. I've heard Meg talk about the same thing for the last 34 songs in a row that she's on. How much more of the same? This is why Doja Cat is my favorite female rapper, because she switches it up at least. Meg right now for me is the female version of DaBaby. Just the same shit over and over, same flow, same cadence, same style, same subject matter. Just eh. I mean, dude, rappers talk about fucking bitches all the time. Meg, is this your burner account? Megan is my name? Nah, just kidding. But I mean, I don't. To be fair to female rappers, I fucking can't stand when men do it too. I hate dudes that talk about getting bitches. Can you be less one-dimensional for me, please? I would probably skip that because of Megan Thee Stallion. If it was just Lil Nas X, I would probably bump it. But Meg, I just couldn't get past it. Tella the Dominicas is next.
Woke up on the floor. Oh, this plastic bed don't blow up no more.
Sometimes
we're
angry, sometimes
we're hurt. I've been living in my lowest
estate. Oh.
Ain't nothing like I hoped it would be. Out on my own. My head, I can't dream, and I just woke up on the floor.
I fucking love Lil Nas X right now. I love the subject matter that we're getting. I should have known because Montero was a really like deep song underneath. I think the subject matter of Montero got like watered down in the public eye because of the lap dancing on the devil, taking a stripper pole down to hell. I think it got overshadowed by that. But Montero was technically a deep song. But bro, this right here.
Sometimes we're angry, sometimes we're
living in my lowest, it's safe to
bro. Whoever produced this album, the sound engineer, the mixer and master, like whoever that person was, chef's kiss, bro.
Her face.
That violin. Ooh. I'm a fucking slut for violins, guys. for strings, for horns. That's all you got to put in an instrumental. And I'm like, fucking 10. Nah, but even for real, that song, much better than Dollar Sign Slime. That is an 8 for me because I like what he's saying. He's talking about like the struggle. We only see Lil Nas X the meme because he wants to be a meme, because he's just like everybody else in this generation. They like memes. They like jokes. They like fucking, you know, viral shit on Instagram and Twitter. But he's still a person who's gone through trials and tribulations after all. And tracks like that, fire, bro. Next up, we got Sun Goes Down. We only have like three or four songs left. Don't Speak by No Doubt.
You need an instant ease from your life where you got...
You know what it is about the album? The album sounds so clean. Like, the production sounds clean. It sounds like every T is crossed, every I is dotted. You know, like, it's so detailed.
That you want to cry, but it's much more to life than dying over your past mistakes and people who do dirt on your name.
There's much more to life than your past mistakes and people that threw dirt on your name.
I was thinking when my lips so big, was I too dark? Oh. My fears. It's hard for you when you're fighting, and nobody knows it when you're silent.
This shit is deep, son. It's so hard when you're fighting and nobody knows because you keep it on the inside, bro. There was another line in there that he said. He said, why are my lips so big? Like, why am I different than everybody else? Why do they keep on picking on me? Bro, Pretty, he is 100% going to save lives. He's going to save the lives of kids and teenagers and people who don't want to come out of the closet because they fear, you know, rejection or abandonment of their parents or family. Somebody like Lil Nas X is going to come through and make them realize that even somebody at this level of stardom felt the same way that they do. It's a hot take,
but it's much more to life than dying over your past mistakes.
I know you want to cry, but there's much more to life than dying because of your past mistakes and people who throw dirt on your name. Guys, that was a fucking 9. That might be a 9.5 because of the melancholic nature, the somber like sound, and then like the very angelic melody of the guitar and his deep voice singing and what he's talking about. Like, he is, like, Pretty's right. He's 100% going to save lives with this track. Like, no question about it. And somebody else said it earlier. Let me see if I can scroll back. H. Zahn, my boy Zahn, he said 1-800, which is the track by Logic about suicide, walked so that way he could run with this track. I think this is a better track than 1-800 because this is much more personal. 1-800 is good, but it has a very, like, we're going to be all right type of feel about it. Where this track right here is like, there's no guarantees that you're going to be all right, but I promise it will get easier. You know what I'm saying? All right, guys. There has not been a miss on this album. Dollar Sign Slime, I don't even consider that a miss because it's Meg that's going to make me not listen to it. Not Lil Nas X. Every song here is 1,000% better musicianship than I thought that we were going to get. Next up, this is the longest song on the album, and I'm expecting it to be kind of heavy because the song title is Void. How many more songs? We got 3.
Hello, friend from the road. I wanted to write a note.
Is he talking to himself?
Oh, it's so much to do and so little of time. I feel like I feel a little behind. It seems so out of reach, the place I wanna be. Find it hard to get. I wrote for you to say I'm gonna run away from home.
The progression of this track right here, the where his voice has gone on this track from super deep to super high, now in a falsetto, and then and you can hear the drums coming in slowly and quietly. Bro, but yeah, we stream.
I weep through the night, can't find a love who loves me the same or as much as you do.
Is he saying hold on or is he saying hold or like in Game of Thrones? Either way, sad.
I reach out my hand, hoping that they'll see I'm more than what everyone tells me. Tired of the way I've been living. Trapped in the long. looking for love around the night.
This is amazing, bro. Not the strings. Guys, motherfucking sheesh. I knew that that song was going to be sad. The name of the song is Sad Void. It's like he's running from one void and running into a void. Like he can't avoid, no pun intended, he can't avoid it. Trey, you're saying 9.5? I'm going to have to agree with you, yo. It's not going to be my most listened to song on the album, but that might be the best song on the album. The production of the whole instrumental, we never got like a drop into like a full production. It kind of just stayed floating up here heavenly, and it's just like the dichotomy between the heavenly sound and then the rushing of the drums and then the sadness of the lyrics just all comes together. That's a 9. Too slow? I mean, it is a slow song. It's supposed to be, because it's a very, he's talking about a very sad moment in his life or in anybody's life who's potentially going through that. After this, we need a bop, like a serious bop. You're right, Murder. After this, we're going to check out some cringe with that new Tom Mac, and then we'll go into some actual music. Not saying that Tom's not actual music, but he's not. 13, don't want it. Let's go. If I say so, no, they gon' ride. Salary, but he don't want it. He don't want it. Oh, I know everything's gonna be alright. This song right here, after Void, tell the Reaper he don't want it with me. He don't want the smoke. Come get this static, boy. I smoke myself to sleep. I'm sad. I think I'm feeling lonely.
You can have anything right before your eyes. The number one song on the Billboard Hot 100, Call Me By Your Name.
Hey, Megan, sorry for shitting on your verse, but it's the only bad one on the album. I wanted fame and I wanted riches. Wanted happiness, wanted forgiveness. I've done things in my past. I'm sorry for so, please don't hold me. Did you hear that fucking clap? The clap was crazy. I guarantee you the producer spent like 10 minutes on that one fucking clap. Tell the Reaper he don't want it. Bro, Void and Don't Want It back to back is the best moment of the album. That right there is the best moment on the album. We just heard it, ladies and gentlemen. And that track right there is going to get people hyped to not commit suicide. It's going to be like, oh, I was sad with him in Void and I feel exactly like this. But the Reaper don't want it with me, bitch. Make it be known. We ride out at dawn. That was hard. That was an 8.5 for me. It might be a 9 only in succession with Void. Like if we listen to those two tracks back to back. To be honest, maybe Sun Goes Down. No, maybe Tales of Dominica, Sun Go Down, Void, and Don't Want It. In order right there. All right, we got two more songs. Life After Salem and then Am I Dreaming with Miley. But yeah, that track's progression. That track's like aggression toward the subject matter. Crazy nice. Almost a 10 for that drop alone. No shit. All of my feelings are gone. Man, who's to blame if you don't love me no more? That kick is crazy. Who's to blame if we don't love you no more? Why don't you just take what you want from me? What you want from me? Yeah. What you want? I was not ready for that, guys. That was fucking... This song is super sad. For someone that said it's depressing, it is depressing. These are emotions that he fully suppressed that he's letting out on his first album. Suppressing these for years. You know what I'm saying? And this is called Life After Salem, and I wonder if it's called that because this is like his life after being, you know, after being hunted like a witch, like in Salem's witch trials. Like, what is life like after y'all hunted me and killed me down and shot me down? You know what I'm saying? Like emotionally. Nirvana and Broken Whiskey Glass off of Stony from Post Malone. Like Billie Eilish is happier than you. Kick me when I have to crawl. Ooh, I love it when you show no love at all. Our scars, they'll dance by the channel. Why don't you just take what you want from me? What you want? So good, bro. Yeah. Kyler. I could see Cudi on almost every song. I 100% would say that Kid Cudi was one of Lil Nas X's direct inspiration, specifically Man on the Moon Part 1, because Man on the Moon Part 1 was depressing, just like this, in a different way. So it was about being a loner, and it was about, like, you know, being alone and coping with your emotions and sadness, and this is very much like that. This sounds like, if you just watch a movie, this sounds like the ending credits of the movie. You know what I'm saying? This is the track that goes over the ending credits, like 21 Pilots did with Heathens. So dark. That song is so dark, so eerie. It reminds me of like a foggy day in London when Jack the Ripper is still yet to be found. That's what I feel like. Like, I feel nervous and scared listening to that song. That's such a very fucking excruciatingly detailed, like, emotion that I'm feeling. And specific, yeah, the specificity is crazy. But that's what I feel like. Would be perfect for James Bond ending credits. Nib Nob, 1,000%. If Billie Eilish didn't fucking murder Ain't No Time to Die, this would have been a perfect song for that. Last song on the album, It's the Climb remix featuring Miley Cyrus. It's the climb.
Every song, every dream filled with hell from me. Story.
As I'm singing, I relive this story.
Shattered inside, but I still got a smile. Battered in blue, but I gotta go on.
This is the last song on the album, so he's like, yo, all of this shit that I've gone through in my life, of all the songs that I've been telling y'all, the whole story that I've been telling y'all, I relive it in my music. And I must be dreaming. There ain't no way I'm actually here. Never forget me like I'm your favorite song.
And everything I've done.
Bro, don't tell me that was him jumping into the water to commit suicide. That wasn't that, right? It could be, though, because the song is like, don't forget me and everything that I've done. You know what I'm saying? Guys. Holy fuck. Let me go ahead and tell you, I plan on spending an hour on Lil Nas's album. I thought we were going to listen to 4 or 5 songs, catch the vibe, have some laughs. Can he top Old Town Road? I don't know. Let's find out. Bro, that shit right there was nothing what I thought it was going to be. Probably drowning Megan for that shit verse. If I was Lil Nas X and Meg turned in that verse and I listened to the entire album together along with that verse, I would have been like, all right, her verse is getting cut. I don't care how much I paid her. So this album right here, Range of Emotions. This is clearly an album of a younger gay male who just came out, wants the world to know that he's serious about his music. Like, yes, the marketing. Yes, him being pregnant on Twitter. Yes, him having like tits, yes, him being a troll, the devil shoes, all of that. It's all fun and games. It's all just trolling. There's nothing serious going on about it. He's just being Lil Nas X. But when he's like, all right, my album is out, actually listen to the album, it's like, holy shit, this dude is a musician. He's not some internet troll like 6ix9ine who stays relevant because of his trolling. This album right here is probably going to be in contention for album of the year at the Grammys in the pop category and overall album of the year. I would be very, very surprised if it's not, because we had rap, we had pop, we had punk rock, we had rock, we had slow ballads. We had Elton John on the fucking album. You know what I'm saying? This is an amazing debut. I don't think it really falls flat in any situation. I don't think there's a single song in here where I said I didn't like outside of $Slime. And if there's one song in the album that doesn't belong in the overall aesthetic, it's $Slime. But it does belong in the aesthetic because he's giving us a break from the sadness and the somberness of the album. So it does belong. Meg didn't belong. But the whole album for me is probably like an 8. Even if he wasn't a troll, even if he wasn't Lil Nas X and didn't troll us all, this is still a good album.